my name is Taylor Rafford. I'm going to be starting us off with our Globus presentation today. Our team name was Haruru. Just telling you a little bit what we're going to tell you about today. First, we're going to start off with our strategy and tell you how we implemented it, went about going and making it up. And then we're going to go over our performance and how that strategy played out throughout the years in Globus. And then we're going to go over our takeaways that we kind of learned from our strategy. And then we'll end with telling you a little bit about our team. Okay, so going right into our strategy, we decided to do the differentiation and overall cost strategy. The way we went about this was really trying to combine the average features with also the top of the line features so that we could create a product that was a bit of above average in the market. We didn't want to price ourselves out and be the top of the line, and so we went ahead and went through the products and the features to see which ones we could add without creating this huge cost that we had through manufacturing. And so we did that with the camera first, by prioritizing those features that we felt that the consumer would be willing to pay a premium for. Not necessarily that it would be the best camera out there, but it would definitely like create value and have some extra things that maybe a lot of the other products didn't. We felt like those were the photo modes, the extra features, and then definitely the editing and sharing capabilities. We thought that those were a good one to select because they didn't add on our cost, and then also it didn't make us like have to price ourselves out, like I said. We also increased our top housing and included accessories. We felt like that definitely had an overall quality look to it. It made us look as if we were above the average consumer and the average product that they were selling. And so we definitely feel like that was the best decision in the camera. And then for the drone, we went with a above the average line as well. We felt like the consumer normally has like a more knowledgeable base to go off of when making their decision about the drone. They definitely do a lot more research and everything like that. So they're gonna be purchasing a very expensive product. So we went ahead and picked out those features that we felt like could not price us out again. We decided those were the GPS, the Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi features. And then we also added extra performance features. And then again, with that top body frame construction, we felt like that would give the consumer value that we could charge them a premium for, but it won't be too big to where we'd be pricing ourselves again out of that budget. So I mean, again, like our goal was to be within the average price range, but at the top of that average price range, not to be the best or the highest quality overall. We found that for the camera, the image quality and then the image sensor size definitely was one of the core components that we felt like could just stay at an average level. And then for the drone, we put at an average level the rotors and then the obstacle sensors. And so we felt like combining those average features with the top features that I talked about, it really helped us, again, create that quality and that value for the customer, but also not at a huge, super large price range. A few other things I wanted to touch on with our strategy was with our marketing. We went ahead and kind of separated those regions. We decided that North America and then Europe, Africa, we could treat as, for the most part, one region. We set the prices extremely close to value. We spent about the same marketing and everything in those categories. And then in Latin America and Asia Pacific, we thought that those also had a lot of similarities, and so those were kind of priced and our marketing was allocated in very similar ways throughout those regions. The price point, like I said earlier, was we want to make sure that we weren't the highest price, but we were one of the highest price in the average budget line. And then in our warranty, again, to create that value and show that we are a company committed to quality, we went ahead and did the higher warranty. That did increase our costs a lot in the manufacturing aspect because of those warranty claims. But with that, we also increased our training, and then we increased a lot of the things that we had in our manufacturing to make sure that we could keep those warranty costs down and that those consumers would not have to file those warranty claims to begin with. Throughout implementing our differentiation and overall cost strategy, I felt like we really didn't run into that many problems. The only one that I would say is definitely our evaluation aspect. We didn't exactly set goals or anything of like where we wanted our market share and then our average price to be. As those started to decline and some increase over the years in Globus, we kind of didn't know exactly if we were doing well or what we wanted to do other than meeting those investor expectations. So I think that maybe if we had set better goals and defined those in the beginning, we wouldn't have run into these problems. But throughout the years, we did end up seeing that we kind of like lost ourselves in this strategy and were unsure of like how to evaluate and how we were doing with that strategy. And now I'll pass it along to Daniel, who's going to talk about our team performance.
Thank you, Taylor. My name is Daniel. I will be talking about the team performance and as well as adaptations that we have done to our initial strategy. Overall, our team performance, it started off relatively well, meeting investor expectations. As you can see here, our earnings per share, it was growing exponentially up until year 12, which I will touch base upon in a couple of seconds. And then it kind of went down after year 12, with our ultimate year 14 being at $1.58 earnings per share. Our return on equity maintained relatively steady, going up until year 14. Our stock price, it also grew, and our credit ratings, our image ratings, we tried to maintain them growing steadily. For the most part, like I said, our team performance relatively well. After year 12, we noticed that our price per drone and price per camera, it was relatively high compared to the industry average. Even though we had a high PQ rating, which we thought merited the costly products, we decided to kind of change our strategy and implement a lower cost for higher quality product. It ended up burning us, which is why we declined on our earnings per share, return on equity, credit rating, and stock price after year 12, which explains that. Even though those areas declined, we did notice, and which is what we were trying to do, our market share went up. So as you can see in North America, Europe, Africa, Asia Pacific, and Latin America, after year 12, our market share, it grew, not significant, but we thought it is, compared to the industry. And we realized, or we were hopeful, if this would continue, that would be more beneficial to us in the long run and boost our revenues, and then we could implement marketing and advertising strategies that would push these areas to purchase our products. Okay. Now I'm going to talk about the strategic and operating performance of our team. As I mentioned before, our PQ rating remains steady. We tried to implement a high PQ, higher cost product, but after year 12, we decided to change that strategy to a higher PQ, lower cost strategy. And as you can see here, we did raise our PQ ratings for both of our products, the drone and the camera, after year 12. We also raised our compensation per PAT member on those, hoping that could drive or the incentive for them to not shortfall. As you can see here also, it kind of went up exponentially on year 14 to $37,185 per member for the camera and $38,340 for the drone. Our operating profit, as I mentioned, because we implemented a strategy in after year 12, and I don't think that Globus really liked that. So our operating profit went down a lot. But because we gained that market share that I spoke about earlier, and our productivity is going up, our labor costs have gone down, our production costs have gone down, if this were to continue, I do believe that we would have raised our revenues, also our competition. We would have been probably higher up in the year to goal date. But it did serve as a learning experience, and I do think that getting to know how the simulation worked in regards to all these metrics, it was relatively difficult at the beginning, And because we decided to change our strategy, that did burn us a little, but I do feel like we did change it for the better long term. And now Alex is gonna talk.
Throughout the simulation, our team learned many prominent lessons pertaining to strategy and strategic management. At Hurahu, the lessons we learned during the simulation spanned through the entirety of a business's life cycle. From the earliest stages of business plan development to the implementation and monitoring of new ideas, as well as the post-analyzation of the impact, either positive or negative, of a new strategic implementation. Some prominent takeaways from the simulation were, first, team communication and just how crucial it is for a project of this scale. Creating an environment where all team members feel comfortable and encouraged to share allows for unique viewpoints that can bring useful insight when creating your business strategy. Second thing we took away was how important it is to work out every single detail of your business strategy before bringing the company into the desired market. Having every detail already worked out and thought of will ensure the highest chance of company success. The third thing we took away from the simulation was how important it would be to brainstorm potential scenarios that could possibly arise as a result of competitor strategies. By contemplating and finding solutions for potential scenarios that could be detrimental to your company's strategy, you give yourself a competitive edge by already having a plan on how to combat your competitor's efforts. The fourth thing we learned was that every aspect of your company's strategy needs to be implemented continually and consistently throughout the entirety of the business's life cycle. If any aspect of your business plan is overlooked or unimplemented, it creates an opportunity for the competition to execute an idea before your business has the ability to. The last thing we took away from the simulation is to always remember the primary goal that your business targets. Your business strategy was created to get your company to where you want it to be in the future. Do not allow a few negative annual results to dictate major unplanned changes to your business's strategy.
Thank you, Alex. So positive is a word that describes our team dynamic. We had very strong communication skills from the beginning. We identified GroupMe as our primary communication tool. We use that application to communicate daily. From the beginning, we set up every Wednesday before the decision year was due to get on the Globus application and communicate through the microphone chat and the communication typing tool. We decided our decision years through that. Our roles for Globus were naturally defined in the beginning in our first meeting. Our majors mirrored the parts of Globus that we understood and cared about. So for example, Taylor and Daniel are accounting and finance majors. Those were the team members in our group that focused primarily on those aspects of Globus. And then myself and Alex, I'm a marketing major and Alex is a management major. We focused on marketing and social responsibility parts of Globus. So for our future decision, if Globus were to run for 3 to 5 years longer, we would better implement our initial strategy of having a premium drone and an above average camera by focusing more on our pricing. We did come in above some of our competitors, so we would have focused a little bit more on that. We would also plan ahead farther by thinking how our decisions would affect year to year versus just going focusing on that year's results. So that's what we would do there. We would also have a plan B to fall back on if our initial strategy didn't work. So we would focus on something else from here on. For example, if Globus were to start over completely, we would implement the low-cost Walmart strategy, which would have put us below our competitors, which worked really well for the team that came in first place. But if we were to implement that, we would focus more on R&D expenditures as they max theirs out in the beginning. We would have liked to implement that strategy while still holding on to our R&D expenditure budget, as well as focusing more on a stronger marketing strategy. We would have liked to been stronger in that area as well. But overall, Globus was a really positive experience for all of us. We learned how to work together, pull all of our different studies in as far as our majors go. And running business is not as easy as it seems. So that is also something we have taken away from this experience. So we really appreciate that, and thank you for your time.
Thank you.